Hi, I'm Dr. Rakesh Yadav. I welcome you to new education session. In this video, I'll talk about fates of pyruvate and citric acid cycle. But before that, if you have not already subscribed to this channel, please consider subscribing right away. Pyruvate, the end product of glycolysis, is a versatile molecule which feeds into numerous pathways. Pyruvate has three fates depending on cellular energy, availability of oxygen, and types of respiration. Firstly, in low oxygen state, hypoxia or anaerobic respiration, if it is handled by yeast cell, pyruvate initially converts into acetaldehyde by releasing carbon dioxide and eventually reduced to ethanol by accepting protons from reduced NAD. This is called alcoholic fermentation. Secondly, in anaerobic conditions, lactobacillus can reduce the pyruvate into lactate by accepting protons from reduced NAD. This is called lactic acid fermentation. Lactate enters the Cori cycle in absence of mitochondria. Thirdly, it can be converted to acetyl coenzyme A for complete oxidation by entering the citric acid cycle and oxidative phosphorylation. But acetyl coenzyme A can be used to make fatty acids in cellular states of high energy. Glycolysis is an oxygen-independent metabolic pathway and occurs in cytosol. However, in eukaryotic cells, the citric acid cycle occurs in matrix of mitochondria. The citric acid cycle, also known as tricarboxylic acid cycle, in short TCA cycle, is a series of chemical reactions exist in all aerobic life forms to release stored energy through the oxidation of acetyl coenzyme A derived from carbohydrates, fats, and proteins into adenosine triphosphate and carbon dioxide. The German-born British biochemist Sir Hans Adolf Krebs proposed this cycle in 1937. That's why it is also called Krebs cycle. For his work, he received the 1953 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine. Although Krebs elucidated most of the reactions in this pathway, there were some gaps in his design. There are 8 basic steps in citric acid cycle. Let us discuss them one by one. Transporter proteins of mitochondrial membrane translocate pyruvate in a symport fashion with a proton. Upon entry to mitochondria, the pyruvate is decarboxylated, producing acetyl coenzyme A. The TCA cycle is initiated when acetyl coenzyme A react with the compound oxaloacetate to form citrate and to release coenzyme A. Then in succession of the reaction, citrate is rearranged to form isocitrate. Isocitrate loses a molecule of carbon dioxide and then undergoes oxidation to form alpha-ketoglutarate. Alpha-ketoglutarate loses a molecule of carbon dioxide and is oxidized to form succinyl coenzyme A. Succinyl coenzyme A is enzymatically converted to succinate. This succinate is further oxidized to fumarate. Fumarate is hydrated to produce malate, and to the end of cycle, malate is oxidized to oxaloacetate. Each complete turn of the cycle result in regeneration of oxaloacetate and the formation of 2 molecules of carbon dioxide. Isocitrate lyase is an example in the glyoxylate cycle that catalyzes the cleavage of isocitrate to succinate and glyoxylate. Together with malate synthase, it bypasses the 2 decarboxylation steps of tricarboxylic acid cycle and is used by bacteria, fungi, and plants. Several of the citric acid cycle intermediates are used for the synthesis of important compounds, which will have significant catabolic effect on the cycle. The regulation of citric acid cycle. There is a multi-tier regulation of TCA cycle. NADH is a product of all dehydrogenases in the citric acid cycle with the exception of succinate dehydrogenase. It inhibits pyruvate dehydrogenase, isocitrate dehydrogenase, alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase and also citrate synthase. Acetyl coenzyme A inhibits pyruvate dehydrogenase, while succinyl coenzyme A inhibits alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase and citrate synthase. Calcium is also used as a regulator in the citric acid cycle. Calcium levels in the mitochondrial matrix can reach up to the tens of micromolar levels during cellular activation. It activates pyruvate dehydrogenase phosphatase, which in turn activates the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. Calcium also activates isocitrate dehydrogenase and alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. This increases the reaction rate of many of the steps in the cycle and therefore increase flux throughout the pathway. Citrate is used for feedback inhibition as it inhibits phosphofructokinase, an enzyme involved in glycolysis that catalyze formation of fructose 1,6-biphosphate, a precursor of pyruvate. This prevents a constant high rate of flux when there is an accumulation of citrate and decrease in substrate for the enzyme. After understanding the pathway for oxidative phosphorylation, we will talk about the theoretical maximum yield of ATP through oxidation of one molecule of glucose in glycolysis, citric acid cycle, and oxidative phosphorylation. That's all about the fates of pyruvate and its entry to citric acid cycle. You must consult the biochemistry textbook for elaborative detail of citric acid cycle. Thank you.